Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. It's Clint Jones here. You're rolling with Popo Jones today. I got Reese here with me. Check out this awesome NASCAR we've got here behind me. That's our topic for today. Let's jump right in it.
Yeah, Clint, well, thanks for coming out. My name is Reese Riddle, and this is the Red Baron Garage. We do a little bit of everything. I do paint corrections and ceramic coatings and detail work and basic maintenance stuff. So a little bit of everything out here, anything car related. Try to be as eclectic as we can be. We've got a bunch of Porsches behind you. We're heavily Porsche based, but Dad likes some of the old American muscle, and we're missing a 65 Corvette there in the corner. But a little bit of everything in here for sure. Yeah, so that's a 1998 Ford Taurus, but it's not a regular Ford Taurus. It's a Roush Racing 351 Cleveland Mark Martin NASCAR, and he ran it in 98. I think this car ran 7 races, and it was one of Mark Martin's best seasons. It was a 7-win season, so it's pretty impressive. There was a few cars that they ran in 98, and this is, you know, one of the I think 4 that they ran that season. So Talladega and Daytona, this car ran. This is a super speedway car, and so it's the big oval tracks is where this car ran. Just looking at it, it's a big car. I was just reading some interviews with Mark Martin. The Ford Taurus at the time, 98, was the ugliest possible car you could buy, but it was the most popular from Ford. And so they had to deal with a big four-door sedan as opposed to the Thunderbird, the two-door Thunderbird that ran before this. Yeah, so this is it's a 351 Cleveland, which is honestly what you would find in your trucks and big cars at the time. But obviously it's been bored and stroked out. This car, when it ran, was close to 800 horsepower. When we had the engine redone, we brought it down closer to 700, 750 or so, just to be able to use the car for longevity purposes. We've had the NASCAR for 3 or 4 years now. We picked it up from an estate sale. Actually, it happened to be pretty local to us, and a guy had a car collection of 80 or 90 cars, and this is the one we ended up with. It was an auction company that came in, and they put everything up for auction. It was pretty inexpensive car to get into, but obviously a lot of work went into it after the fact.
Now, I'll be honest with you, I've never gone out and just looked around to see who had a NASCAR sitting around in their garage, you know. But I imagine that there's not very many people out there that can say that they've got one of these sitting in their garage. So, how rare are these? How difficult is it to come by something like this?
Now, that's a good point, and it actually presents a bit of an issue, but not a lot of people have NASCARs laying around, and especially ones that are of this vintage. So 98, you're getting to, you know, 20 plus years old. These cars, after they were raced in NASCAR, they went to a lot of smaller league racing, and so a lot of the cars got crashed and destroyed. There's fewer and fewer cars remaining, and a lot of them are sitting in museums and different things like that, in garages like this, where they're brought to car shows, and they're, you know, taken down the road occasionally, and that's it. It was taken care of, and you can see that. This car went to a museum after it was finished with Mark Martin. Went to a museum in Arkansas, is where Mark Martin is from, and unfortunately, the museum went under after 15 years of being open. But so it sat there for a lot of the time. But it's kind of cool to walk around the car, and you view imperfections on this car a little different than you would something that you're trying to sell to a regular old retail customer on the lot. Damage on this car tells a story about when it was racing, and so there's a couple small little dents here and there, and you go back and read through some of the racing history, and you can pinpoint where this little dent happened. It's pretty neat.
That actually is pretty amazing. I mean, to be able to come back and look at the damage on a car, a dent or a ding, and there's a story behind it, and not just, you know, I backed into a mailbox,
yeah,
or something,
right,
like that. You know, it's an amazing story. It's a race story. It's a muscle story. And that, I think, by itself is pretty impressive, because not everybody else out there can say that the ding on their car came from, you know,
Jeff Gordon or whoever.
Exactly,
right.
Yes. So that's pretty amazing.
Originally, we were going to go the vintage racing route. We were going to put this car, the SVRA crew comes to COTA every year, and we've been going to the races for a while, and we thought it would be pretty fun to take this car out on COTA. But we ended up going in a different direction with that, with a different car. But this car, you could get into racing very easily.
What kind of person is looking to buy a car like this?
You got to be kind of crazy, and you got to have really nice, understanding neighbors too. Some of the guys out here are not as appreciative of it as we are. It's obviously very loud, and it attracts a lot of attention, which is great in a lot of circumstances. But when it's a quiet Wednesday evening, I don't know. They don't want to hear this thing going to the grocery store. So, but we've done it. Yeah, so we're a little east of Dallas, not too far, about 100 miles east of Dallas. It's an interesting place to have a car like this because there's not a lot of law enforcement just directly around us, and so we're able to take the car up and down the road, like I said, until the neighbors have had enough, and then they call somebody in.
I think what you're telling me is that if somebody, a prospective buyer, wanted to come and check out this car, that they could possibly, make a little noise down the road.
Oh, yeah. For sure. We'll have to go a certain direction because some of the guys down there don't like us very much. But we'll go this way, and we'll be in good shape for sure. Yeah, find me on Instagram, the Red Baron Garage. Shoot me a message there. We're thinking about posting the car on Bring a Trailer. So if you'd like to come see the car, check it out, and maybe run it down the road, you can certainly do that and look for the listing on Bring a Trailer. It's big, it's fast, it's loud. It's a lot of fun. It's scary. It's a scary car to drive. I've had a lot of track experience driving on the track with different cars and different horsepower level cars, and this is one that's I haven't quite tamed yet. I hadn't figured this one out. It's 750 horsepower with next to no weight. It's an interesting combination.
Well, Reese, that was a whole lot of fun. I really appreciate you having us out at the Red Baron Garage and letting us check out your NASCAR and learn all there is to know about it.
Oh, yeah.
So thank you guys for tuning in. I look forward to catch you on the next one. And if you guys enjoyed this video, please give me a like and subscribe for more content. And also give Reese a follow on Instagram. What was the name of your Instagram?
The Red Baron Garage.
The Red Baron Garage. So you guys check that out as well. And we'll see you on the next one.